All right, so this is a sugar maple, and I had bought this tree. I got it from the Arbor Day Foundation. Like, if you make a donation, they'll send you like 20 or 30 trees. And this was one of the trees that they sent me. It was bare root. Most of those trees died that I did receive from them, but this one is one of the ones that survived. And the only reason why it did survive is because I potted this one in soil down here. As you can see, this was not meant to be grown like this. This is gonna have to come out of here sooner or later. I just sat it here. This tree has been basically sitting here since like 2012 or 13. Because right around the time when I built the greenhouse and the pond is when I had all of these extras just sitting in pots and stuff sitting around the edge of my pond. And this has been sitting here for a long time, and it's never really grew. It just kind of sat there. Well, I guess the roots found its way out of the holes on the bottom, and now we have a full growing tree here that either I'm going to have to leave or I'm going to have to remove. And I really don't want to have a giant maple tree growing right here, because it's right next to my greenhouse and next to my pond. This is going to have to get moved. But this is a sugar maple, and I figured I'd show you this because, like I say, I don't know if I'm going to keep it or I'm going to rip it out or replant it. And I don't know, it can't stay here though. Right now it's cool right here because, you know, you can see I kind of got some fences up there to keep the deer out from crossing in here. But as you can see, it's pretty nice. If those fences weren't here and this tree was gone, it'd be a nice little scenic tree to have where you walk through. Doesn't bother me. But it can't stay here because this tree is going to probably get as big as that maple. We just simply can't have that here. This has got to get moved. But I wanted to show this to you because I believe you could milk these. This is probably too young to try to get sap out of this tree. But I can try it. I can try to get a little sap towards the bottom of the tree down here. I might try and tap it a little bit and see if we can get some sap in the, I don't know, is it the winter time? There's a certain time of the year you have to tap these when the sap starts flowing. So it's probably springtime. So I'll probably do an update video to this, and I'll tap that tree a little bit to see if we can get some sap running out of it. And I guess the spring is when you're supposed to do it. I mean, if anybody has sugar maples and they do tap them for maple syrup, if you know exactly when you're supposed to tap these, that would be great. But I'm pretty confident that it is sometime in the spring. There's a small window when you can actually... There's a small window when you can actually tap these. When the sap is running, you can get the most sugar out of it. So, but I know it's not meant to be tapped because it is a little small to do it. But we'll do it anyway because I got to do something with this tree. And even if I could get a little sap just to taste it for you and describe what the sap will taste like fresh out of the tree, that's pretty much all I would really want to do. I'm not looking to get like a big quart full of sap so I can make pancakes and waffles and things. Just enough for me to taste it and describe it. So, but yeah, I just wanted to show you my sugar maple that I have. Like I say, if anybody does grow these and they have any comments or anything on them, feel free to comment below, share your thoughts. That's it. If you like this video, like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you on the next one. Take care.